A very good morning. You're watching Rajya Sabha Television. I'm Smriti Rastogi with Breakfast News. Let's begin the bulletin with the top headlines of this morning. Terror strikes Spain, 13 dead, more than 100 injured as van hits crowd in Barcelona. IS claims responsibility. Police stop second attack in Cambrils. 5 suspects killed in the shootout. World leaders united in their condemnation of Spain terror attacks. Spanish Prime Minister says jihadist terrorism requires global response. MEA says no report of any Indian casualty. Support for India in Doklam standoff with China. Japan says no one should try to change status quo by force. Prime Minister Narendra Modi interacts with young entrepreneurs at the Champions of Change initiative organized by Niti Aayog. Highlights the small changes made by the centre that have brought significant results for the country. And flood situation in Bihar and Assam worsens. Lakhs being affected in both the states. 119 people dead in Bihar, 49 in Assam. And straight to the big development of this morning, at least 13 people were killed and more than 100 injured in Spain as a van ploughed into a crowd of people in Barcelona. Terror group IS has claimed the responsibility for the attack. Spanish police arrested 2 people in connection with the case, but the driver of the van is on the run. Police also have foiled a second attack attempt in the town of Cambrils, in which 5 attackers were gunned down.
Terror struck Spain on Thursday as a van rammed into crowds in the city of Barcelona, killing at least 13 people. Witnesses said the van zigzagged down Las Ramblas, which is one of Barcelona's busiest tourist destinations, mowing down pedestrians and leaving bodies strewn across the ground. Terror group Islamic State claimed responsibility for the attack.
De la tarde, voy por la calle atrás de la Rambla. Alle 5:05 della tarde ho escuchato un rumore molto forte. Era sulla furgonetta che si è schiantato sull'edicola.
Police announced the arrest of 2 suspects but said that the driver was still on the run. Meanwhile, Spanish police say that they have killed 5 people in the town of Cambrils to stop a second attempted van attack. The attackers were wearing explosive belts. Prime Minister Mariano Rajoy has called for a global response to jihadist terrorism. Spain's royal family has vowed that their country would not be terrorized by extremists.
Quiero expresar también la solidaridad de toda España con la ciudad de Barcelona, hoy golpeada por el terrorismo yihadista, como antes lo fueron otras ciudades en todo el mundo.
Parlant d'un acte de dimensions molt greus i que volem condemnar enèrgicament. La democràcia i els valors intrínsecs que en són, de la llibertat i la igualtat.
The incident took place at the height of the tourist season in Barcelona, which is one of Europe's top travel destinations, with at least 11 million visitors a year. Spain was earlier hit by a jihadist attack in March 2004 when bombs exploded on commuter trains in Madrid, killing 191 people in an attack claimed by Al-Qaeda-inspired extremists.
Is there anything else that might happen? Is it just everything is safe? We don't know if we should leave the area or stay here, whether tomorrow going to be safe, everything going to be back to normal, or we just have to go back home.
The rampage yesterday in a city hugely popular with tourists from around the world is the latest in a wave of attacks in Europe where vehicles have been used as weapons of terror. On Thursday night, Eiffel Tower went dark in tribute to the victims of Barcelona attack. Bureau report, Rajya Sabha TV.
The attack in Barcelona has drawn widespread condemnation from leaders across the world. The attack follows similar incidents in Britain, Germany and France. US President Donald Trump tweeted, "The United States condemns the terror attack in Barcelona, Spain, and will do whatever is necessary to help." He added, "Be tough and strong. We love you." France's President Emmanuel Macron, whose country has witnessed a series of bloody jihadist atrocities, including a truck rampage in Nice in July 2016 that killed 86 people, said his thoughts were with the victims of the tragic attack. The spokesman for German Chancellor Angela Merkel condemned the revolting attack, and British Prime Minister Theresa May said on Twitter that she was sickened by the senseless loss of life in Barcelona, adding that London stands with Spain against terror. Condemning the attack, the United Nations Secretary General Antonio Guterres also extended his condolences to the families of those killed.
The United States condemns this terror attack, and we will do whatever is necessary to help. Whatever inspired today's terror attack, the United States stands ready to assist the people of Spain and find and punish those responsible. On this dark day, our prayers and the prayers of all the American people are with the victims, their families, and the good people of Spain.
Meanwhile, External Affairs Minister Sushma Swaraj has said that there was no report of any Indian casualty in the Barcelona terror attack. Sushma Swaraj said that she was in constant touch with the Indian embassy in Spain. Swaraj also retweeted emergency numbers in Barcelona given by the Indian embassy. In a tweet, she said, "I'm in constant touch with the Indian embassy in Spain. As of now, there is no report of any Indian casualty." On to some more news. In a significant act of support for India in its protracted military standoff with China at Doklam, near the Sikkim-Tibet-Bhutan tri-junction, Japan has said there should be no attempt to change the status quo on the ground by the force. The Japanese statement comes as an endorsement of the Indian position that China has violated agreements with the Indian and Bhutan countries in attempting to build a road through Doklam Plateau, which is part of Bhutan, a development that would be a serious disadvantage to India's military defenses. Japanese Ambassador Kenji Hiramatsu's observation on the Doklam comes 2 months after Indian troops stalled Chinese road construction activities and is seen as endorsing India's stance as being important for a peaceful resolution. The Japanese reaction follows 2 separate interventions by the US calling for direct dialogue between India and China to resolve the crisis while cautioning against unilateral changes on the ground. Even as India maintains status quo on the Doklam border in Sikkim, it's also assessing the overall border situation in China. China, on the other hand, seems keen to be using wrong precedents to make its case. While the Chinese government has adhered to none of the treaties in the past, it is practicing double standards in the present stalemate.
Chinese claims over the land in Doklam area are not backed by facts. China is citing an 1890 treaty between the British and the Chinese emperor, when in truth neither Bhutan or Sikkim were party to that treaty. Experts say this was a treaty of convenience that Imperial Britain and China signed on March 17, 1890 in Calcutta. The treaty didn't take Tibet into confidence, even though it was an independent country, and the treaty dealt with water sharing between Sikkim and Tibet. Consequently, even Tibet refused to recognize the treaty. Experts say that misquoting history is part of the Chinese ploy to grab land and expand its boundaries.
Really strange that now China has gone on to accept the 1890 treaty or the agreement as the baseline to make its territorial claims. So I think in a sense what China is trying to do is, where it is convenient to them, they want to kind of play by these historical agreements and treaties, but otherwise they will not.
But even as China refers to the 1890 treaty to stake its claim on Doklam, it doesn't mention the McMahon line between India and China. The McMahon line was drawn between British and the then Tibet regime in 1914. It was signed by McMahon, the then Foreign Secretary of Britain, and Lonchen Sathra on behalf of the Tibetan government. India recognizes it as an international boundary between India and modern China, but China does not.
The Chinese refuse to accept the McMahon line, which which is the borderline between India and China, on the premise that this is the leftover from a British era, and therefore, why is India falling prey to that? But this is really strange.
The Chinese duplicity on boundary issues is glaring. It recognizes facts according to convenience and released a 15-page document to insist on the 1890 treaty. India has virtually rejected this, which is why its forces are refusing to budge against any Chinese misadventure of attempts to distort history.
India needs to expose this mindset of China. From Doklam to South China Sea, this is the same mindset that is destabilizing the whole world. Akhilesh Suman for Raj Sabha Television with camera person Junaid in Delhi.
And in a major decision, the Defense Ministry on Thursday cleared a proposal to procure 6 Apache helicopters from American giant Boeing for the Army. The acquisition of the helicopters, equipment and training will cost 4,168 crore rupees. Defense Ministry said that 6 AH-64E helicopters will come along with the associated equipments, spares and weapon systems. Sources said the decision was taken in Defense Acquisition Council meeting chaired by Defense Minister Arun Jaitley in New Delhi. The council also approved procurement of 2 gas turbine engines for naval ships at the cost of 490 crore rupees. The attack helicopters, which are expected to be delivered by 2020, will significantly enhance armored division and will strengthen the army's capability to carry out combat operations in border areas. Prime Minister Narendra Modi has lauded the new ideas and innovations envisaged by the young entrepreneurs as he interacted with them at the Champions for Change initiative organized by Niti Aayog in the national capital on Thursday.
More than 200 young entrepreneurs got a chance to interact with Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Thursday in the national capital. The Prime Minister emphasized that the new India could only be built through the efforts of crores of ordinary citizens and invited the entrepreneurs to join this effort.
Sarkar ki koshish hai ki desh ke har kone mein har vyakti ke paas kuch na kuch hai dene ke liye. Hum ise जोड़ना चाहते हैं और सरकार को फाइल से बाहर निकाल करके जन जीवन के साथ जोड़ना चाहते हैं ये टू वे हमारा प्रयास है
PM termed the Champions for Change initiative organized by Niti Aayog as an effort to bring together diverse trends for the benefit of the nation and its society. He said a lot of small changes have been brought in by the union government which have brought significant results.
Corruption भी दुर्भाग्य से इंस्टीट्यूशनलाइज हो गया है जब तक आप काउंटर इंस्टीट्यूशनल अरेंजमेंट नहीं करते हैं आप उसको रोक नहीं पाते हैं
Six groups of young entrepreneurs made presentations before the PM on various themes such as soft power, Incredible India 2.0, education and skill development, health and nutrition, energizing a sustainable tomorrow and digital India, new India by 2022. Vishal Dayas report for Rajya Sabha TV.
Let's take a look at all the other national news and nationwide. Gujarat Chief Minister Vijay Rupani visited civil hospitals in 4 major cities of state to take stock of the situation in swine flu cases. The death toll due to H1N1 virus has risen to 230. Rupani has requested the center to send a team of medical experts to the state to suggest steps to prevent the spread of the disease. National Investigation Agency will today produce Zahoor Ahmed Shah Watali, arrested in connection with a terror funding case in Jammu and Kashmir, before the special NIA judge at Patiala House Court. Yesterday, Watali was arrested following the searches conducted by the agency at multiple locations in Jammu and Kashmir belonging to his relatives and employees. The NIA had unearthed highly incriminating material pertaining to receipt of funds by Watali from foreign sources and its further distribution to the terrorists and separatists in the Kashmir Valley for the anti-India activities. An army jawan and his father were injured along the line of control in the Nowshera sector of Rajouri district as the Pakistan army violated ceasefire for the sixth consecutive day on Thursday. Brief small arms were also reportedly fired along the LOC in the Poonch sector. And with that, time for a very short break. More news and updates on the other side. Stay with us.
National Institute for Research in Tuberculosis, in fact, has done extensive work on vaccine research related to TB, especially with the BCG vaccine. We have now very good treatment for TB, and we have shown that it is possible to cure TB provided the patient takes the treatment properly. Delayed detection of the TB disease results in more transmission in the community.
Watch Eureka with Dr. Srikant Prasad Tripathi, Director at National Institute for Research Tuberculosis, Chennai, only on Rajya Sabha Television.
Thanks for being with us. Amidst raging controversy over the Article 35A of the Constitution of India, the Jammu and Kashmir government, led by Mehbooba Mufti, will today send four top ministers to Delhi to explore further legal support for the state government in the Supreme Court on Article 35A. They are also expected to explain to the leaders at the centre the devastating implications in the case the constitutional provision is struck down and to ensure that Union government backs the state's stance in the Apex Court. The visit of four-member delegation comes just a week after Chief Minister Mufti's three-day tour of New Delhi. The delegation includes Law Minister Abdul Haq Khan and his cabinet colleagues, Finance Minister Haseeb Drabu, Horticulture Minister Syed Bashrat Bukhari and Information, Food and Supplies Minister Chaudhry Zulfikar. Article 35A of the Indian Constitution grants special provisions to the residents of Jammu and Kashmir. On to some more news, Tamil Nadu government has decided to form an inquiry commission to probe the death of the former chief minister and AIADMK leader J. Jayalalitha. In a statement in Chennai, Chief Minister E. Palaniswamy said the commission would be headed by a retired high judge. In another significant development, he has also said that the house where late Jayalalitha was living, the Veda Nilayam in Poyiz Garden in Chennai, would be converted into a memorial in her honour. The AIADMK faction, headed by former Chief Minister O. Paneerselvam, has been demanding a CBI probe into the circumstances leading to the death of late Jayalalitha in December last year. The Paneerselvam's faction had made it a precondition for its merger with the Palaniswamy's faction. He had also demanded the dismissal of Jayalalitha's aide V.K. Sasikala and her relatives from the party. Recently, Palaniswamy faction passed a resolution seeking to nullify Sasikala's nephew, T.T.V. Dinakaran, from the party post. It also said that Sasikala's appointment as the party general secretary is also an interim measure, adding party cadres are not prepared to see anyone in the post which was held by late Jayalalitha. The steps are being viewed to cement ties between the two factions and heading towards a possible merger.
Current Chief Minister Palaniswamy has set up this commission, meets a major demand of Paneerselvam, and this clearly paves the way for merger of the two factions of the AIADMK and their possible merger in the BJP, either as a part of BJP or as a partner in the NDA. We will have to see that.
The flood situation in Assam and Bihar has worsened due to incessant rains, with lakhs of people being affected in both the states. At least 119 people died in Bihar, whereas 98 people died in West Bengal and Assam. The NDRF and the army have been pressed into service to evacuate those stranded.
Unprecedented heavy rains have unleashed floods, wreaking havoc in Bihar, West Bengal and Assam. In Bihar, the flood situation has further deteriorated. At least 119 people have lost their lives and nearly 73 lakh people have been hit in around 14 districts. Indian Army and teams of the State Disaster Relief Force have stepped up rescue operations to evacuate thousands of people displaced by the deluge.
हम लोग SDRF के जवान अभी तक वहां भी जा रहे हैं जहां कहीं रोड नहीं है, चारों तरफ पानी से घिरा हुआ है, उनको हम लोग आप जैसे कि देख रहे हैं कि अभी भी मेडिकल की टीम हमारे सामने आपके साथ में यहां पर दवा वितरण कर रहा है. ऐसे हम लोग तीन दिनों से डॉक्टर के टीम को लेकर के और गांवों में जा करके और जहां पर अभी तक कोई नहीं पहुंचा वहां हम लोग दवा बंटवा रहे हैं.
रिलीफ पहुंचाने में दिक्कत हो रही है कि जो रास्ते हैं वो कई जगह कट गए हैं और पानी इस बार काफी जल्दी आ गया है. फिर भी हम लोगों ने वहां पर जो SDRF की टीम थी उसको पहले ही हम लोगों ने पहुंचा दिया था, तो उसकी वजह से भी हमको इस बात की राहत है कि हमारे रेस्क्यू ऑपरेशंस ठीक से चल रहे हैं और स्थानीय बाजार से जो भी सामग्री कर करके लोगों का जो राहत शिविर है वो हम लोगों ने चालू कर दिया है. मनिहारी बाजार से भी हम लोग सामग्री भेज रहे हैं और बहुत जल्द हम लोग ट्रेन के माध्यम से भी वहां पर सामान भेजने जा रहे हैं.
इन वेस्ट बंगाल द फ्लड सिचुएशन हैज इंप्रूव्ड. अराउंड 17 मोर पीपल हैव लॉस्ट देयर लाइव्स टेकिंग द टोल टू 49 अक्रॉस 6 डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स ऑफ नॉर्थ बंगाल. The Eastern Railway has cancelled all the trains to North Bengal and Northeast till 20th of August. Hundreds of people were stranded at Sialdah railway station due to disruption of train services.
Koi train nahi abhi Malda tak jane ke liye bhi koi train nahi hai. Main ghar ja nahi pa raha hu. Do din se hi par raha hu. Abhi train mein inquiry ki to bol raat 11 baje koi train hoga.
Meanwhile in Assam at least 49 people have died due to floods. Over 31 lakh people are affected across 24 districts. According to Assam State Disaster Management Authority, 67 lakh hectares of crop area has also been damaged. The NDRF, SDRF and district administration personnel have evacuated nearly 3,500 people to safer areas. Bureau report, Rajya Sabha TV.
BJP President Amit Shah will visit Madhya Pradesh today. He will attend a series of meetings, including that of state unit office bearers, address students and meet heads of various social groups. The visit is part of his 110-day nationwide tour to strengthen the party ahead of the 2019 general elections. He is expected to pay tributes to Deen Dayal Upadhyay and Raja Bhoj in Bhopal. BJP Chief Amit Shah on Thursday chaired a meeting of party leaders to chalk out a strategy for Mission 2019 and on ways to bag more than 350 seats. As part of the strategy, Shah asked leaders to focus on the 150 seats which the party lost in 2014 elections. These seats were in various states including West Bengal, Odisha, Karnataka and in the Northeast. The district administration on Thursday submitted its inquiry report into the deaths of over 70 children due to oxygen shortage at a state-run hospital in Uttar Pradesh's Gorakhpur district. The report held a Lucknow-based firm and two senior doctors responsible for disrupting oxygen supply to the hospital. However, the report was silent on the cause of the deaths and who was responsible.
The Gorakhpur District Administration on Thursday sent its inquiry report to the state government. The report on child deaths at the Baba Raghav Das Medical College Hospital in the city pins the blame for mismanagement on two senior doctors. The report by District Magistrate Rajiv Rautela blamed firm Pushpa Sales, Principal R.K. Mishra and Anesthesia Department Head Dr. Satish Kumar responsible for the entire episode. The inquiry panel found the hospital's log about supply of oxygen in a mess. The five-member panel also raised suspicions about corruption and called for a deeper probe. Amid the ongoing controversy over the tragic deaths, Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath is facing opposition criticism over poor health care and corruption at the town's biggest hospital. Congress has demanded a probe supervised by a Supreme Court judge into the tragedy.
100% जो बच्चे हैं वो ऑक्सीजन की कमी की वजह से मरे हैं और उनकी मौत की जिम्मेदार स्टेट गवर्नमेंट है. उससे वो अपने उससे बच नहीं सकती स्टेट गवर्नमेंट, ये उनकी वजह से है.
उनको अधिकारियों ने डार्क में रखा, किसी ने मुख्यमंत्री को ये नहीं बताया कि पेमेंट न होने की वजह से ऑक्सीजन बंद करने का नोटिस दिया है उस कंपनी ने और डीएम की जिम्मेदारी बनती थी कि इसकी व्यवस्था देखे. सब जानते हैं कि ऑक्सीजन जैसे ही बंद होगी बच्चों की डेथ हो जाएगी. तो इसमें दोषी लोगों को बचाने के लिए गवर्नमेंट कोशिश कर रही है, इससे ज्यादा दुखद और कोई बात नहीं हो सकती।
इस कदर लापरवाही, ये एक मिसाल सामने आई है। उत्तर प्रदेश सरकार इसके लिए जवाबदेह है, केंद्र स्वास्थ्य मंत्रालय इसके लिए जवाबदेह है, और अब जबकि डिस्ट्रिक्ट मैजिस्ट्रेट की तरफ से भी ये रिपोर्ट आई है कि इसकी विशेष जो कारण इसका है वो ऑक्सीजन के सप्लाई न होने का है, तो ये बड़े दुख की बात है।
However, the state government as well as the district administration have continually denied reports, blaming disruption in oxygen supply for the deaths. Over 70 children have died at the hospital in the last 10 days as it ran out of medical supplies, triggering anger not only across the state but also across the country. Bureau report, Rajya Sabha TV.
And now the news from the West Bengal. The Trinamool Congress has swept the municipal polls, capturing all the 7 civic bodies which went to polls on August 13th. The ruling party made a clean sweep in Durgapur Municipal Corporation, which is the largest civic body among the 7. Meanwhile, the BJP remained second after it won 4 out of 16 wards in Dhupguri Municipality and 1 ward each in Panskura and Bunyadpur. The CPM-led Left Front won Nalhati Municipal Corporation, and while Congress failed to secure any seat out of 148 wards in 7 civic bodies, TMC won 140 wards, BJP won 6, Left Front won 1, and an independent candidate won 1. And a look at what else is making news across the world in World Wrap. U.S. President Donald Trump has fired back at the growing number of fellow Republicans who denounced his response to the Charlottesville, Virginia violence. In a series of posts on Twitter, Trump lashed out at several Republican senators and said he had not drawn any moral comparisons between the white supremacists and those who opposed them. The weekend violence at the Virginia college town has inflamed racial tensions across U.S. Venezuelan President Nicolas Maduro has instructed the military to prepare to shoulder arms in case of a U.S. invasion. The order comes after U.S. President Donald Trump said last week that he would not rule out a military option to oust Venezuela's president and ruling Socialist Party from the power. On the heels of that statement, Trump's Vice President Mike Pence embarked on a four-nation tour of Latin America to drum up support for a more aggressive push against Maduro and his administration. Tens of thousands of trees have been brought down by storms that wreaked havoc across northern and western Poland. The storms over the weekend killed 6 people. Thousands of homes were also damaged. Poland's chief forester said that he would take up to 2 years to clean up the fallen trees and decades for the loss of natural habitat to recover. And here are some updates from the world of sports and Sports Beat. Sania Mirza and her Chinese teammate Shuai Peng entered the quarterfinals of the Cincinnati Masters. The fourth-seeded pair defeated the German-Ukrainian team of Julia Georges and Olga Shavchuk 7-5, 6-4 in the pre-quarterfinals. The duo will play their quarterfinal match against Romanian pair of Iriana Chimelia Begu and Raluca Olaru. Cristiano Ronaldo and Lionel Messi will again be duelling for the title of the world's best footballer after their names once again headed the shortlist for the best FIFA men's player. The pair have dominated the global award in its varied forms for a decade. They were voted by the national coaches and captains, selected media and fans, with the winners to be announced at the ceremony in London on October 23rd. Two-time Grand Slam winner Victoria Azarenka has expressed her willingness to withdraw her name from the US Open. The 28-year-old has reached the finals of the US Opens in 2012 and 13. The US Open, which is the fourth and final Grand Slam of the year, will be held from August 28th to September 10th in the New York City. And that's all we have for you in this edition of Breakfast News. Keep watching Rajya Sabha Television.